partners. This is not how we plan to do our transition. However, hopefully over the course of this presentation, we'll be able to answer possibly some of the questions and concerns that you might have with regards to your child starting nursery. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Mrs. Allen, and I would like to introduce my nursery teacher, Mrs. Robbins.
Hello.
Who from September will be responsible for the teaching of the children who will be in nursery. I'm moving into reception. I will still support nursery and I will still be available if you need to speak to me. But first and foremost, Mrs. Robbins will be your sort of first port of call if you've got any questions that you need answered. Hopefully, we will put any sort of concerns you've got to rest. It is going to be very different in September, and for those of you who are returning after school closure, we are looking forward to welcoming you back. For those who are joining us for the first time, we're looking forward to welcoming you into nursery. A normal day in nursery, we would ask you to sort of come in, share some reading time with your child, talk to the adults who are in there. Unfortunately, due to COVID, we are not allowed to do any of these at the moment. So at 8:30, myself and Mrs. Robbins will come out with other members of staff who are supporting nursery to meet you and your child at the school gates. You will need to wait outside the gates, and it will be clearly marked to social distance. As of now, those are the guidelines we've been given. We would recommend if you are dropping off and picking up using a car that you use the Innage Lane car park, and a permit can be obtained from the school office for this. We also need you to be mindful of the fact that it's a busy road, and with the whole school due to come back in September, traffic will be increased. And if your child is upset or prone to pulling away or running away, please be mindful that that is a road and you will be waiting on there. So just an extra precaution to be aware of in the mornings. We're also prepared for the fact that some children will be reluctant to come through the gate without an adult to support them. We're working very hard to ensure that that transition we support and is as smooth and as successful as possible. We can't guarantee there won't be tears, yours, ours, all theirs. However, we will try our best to ensure that your child comes through and is confident to leave you at the gate. I can't give you any answers to that because none of us know. What I can say is the children who have returned since June 1st, that has worked extremely well, and the children have managed it really well. And there is a fantastic video on the website that you can watch to sort of see how that works and follow the children's path into school. So I would suggest you have a look at that, so that might sort of like put your mind at rest. What your child will be doing in nursery? Well, first and foremost, transition and settling. We will be working very closely with all children to ensure their emotional well-being, to ensure they are happy, to ensure they are feeling safe, to ensure they are feeling secure away from home. We're not able to meet you in person, but we can phone you and we can contact you, the same as you can phone or contact via the office email, which is on the PowerPoint, which is attached to this presentation. So if there is anything that you really need to know, we are still here till Thursday. However, we are back in September before school opens. Nursery won't reopen until the Thursday of the first week back in September. So over the course of the next few slides, I'm going to talk to you about what to expect and what nursery will be like for your child when they start. Okay, a day in the life of a nursery child. Well, there is not one typical day that I could sort of just talk about now, because obviously every day is different. But when we plan our early years curriculum, we try to ensure that nursery is exciting and that the children have opportunity to learn new things. The EYFS is divided into seven areas, and we try and cover these across different ways. That could be through outdoor learning, through activities we put out for the children to explore in nursery, through forest school, through our physical development. And like I said previously, one of the main things we're going to be looking at is children's emotional and social well-being when they come back, and supporting that transition and making friends. Children will have opportunity to play and learn with an adult, and then the adult will interact while the children are sort of playing their own chosen activities with their new friends. Regular hand washing is going to form a big part of our day, and this is sort of like one of the things we've been told through the guidance, regular cleaning, regular hand washing, and unfortunately some of the resources like sand and Play-Doh won't be available for the children to use, but I don't feel this is going to make a huge difference on their day in nursery. And we intend to make as much as we possibly can your child's experience and day in nursery as fun and as educational as possible.
Tell everybody I'm on my way, new friends and new places to see. With blue skies ahead, yes, I'm on my way, and there's nowhere else that I'd rather be. Tell everybody I'm on my way, and I'm loving every step I take. With the sun
school day. Nursery in the morning will start at 8:30, so we will meet you at the school gate at 8:30, and we need to get everyone in as quickly as we can, because obviously then the rest of the school will start welcoming their classes in. As soon as you come into nursery, we will wash hands and settle ourselves in for the day, and we like to start our morning with a morning yoga. It's just a routine that we follow, it helps everyone settle, and especially in these uncertain times when it's very different, transition, starting a new school for some children coming back, it's just a nice way of bringing everyone back to centre again. We then do the register. We will have activities that support fine gross motor skills to develop handwriting skills. We will have adult focused activities and child initiated activities. Some of these might look slightly different to where your child remembers, the same as the environment will look slightly different, and that's because we've had to reduce the amount of resources that we are able to offer, because part of the day now is ensuring that the environment is kept as clean and as possible to ensure no risk of infection or transmission to your child or anybody. We will have our cafe, but what we're asking at the moment is that children bring in their own healthy snack and a water bottle with the name clearly on it. This is because we're not sure at the moment if we're going to be able to offer milk or snacks to the children. So to begin with in September, we're asking that you provide your own. The morning finishes at 11:30 with singing and phonics and story time, and we will bring those children who are going home at 11:30 back out to meet you at the gate. Children who are staying for lunch, lunchtime will be 11:30 till 12:30, and they will need to bring their own packed lunch, because at the moment the kitchen cannot open for hot meals. You can order a packed lunch, but you need to do that via the office and you need to give notice for that. So what I'm asking is that on that first week back into nursery, or those first 2 days back into nursery on the Thursday and Friday, that you ensure your child has a lunch with them if they are staying all day. And then we can sort of then support if you need to sort of order going forward. The afternoon session starts at 12:30. Any children who are just coming for the afternoon, again, we will come and meet you at the gate and bring you into nursery. One thing you will find, or the children will find during the day, is there's a big increase effort on hand washing when they come into nursery, hand washing before they sort of change activities, hand washing before they have a snack, hand washing before lunchtime, hand washing before they leave. And again, this is all around the guidelines we've been given to ensure that we decrease the risk of any reinfection due to COVID. The afternoon runs very much the same as the morning, with the opportunities to support gross and fine motor skills, develop communication and language through talking, through stories, through play, and finishing the day with sort of circle times, music. And the big focus for us coming back will be what we class as the primaries, which will be your child's sort of social emotional well-being. How are they feeling after being away from nursery for so long? How are they feeling that some of their friends have moved up to big school? New children joining us, how does that feel for them? Ensuring that their emotional well-being is key. So we will be working on that in those first few weeks. Standing Forest School area that has been developed several times over and includes a wooded area where children can climb and explore the mini beasts that live out there. There's a meadow area which allows for sensory exploration and just a place to go and sit and enjoy. And there's areas where they can just climb and take risks that they feel secure with. We do forest school all year round. You will be allocated a day where your child has forest school, and we will inform you of what they need. But it's just to remember that they come properly suited and booted. They will need wellies or sensible outdoor shoes. They will need long trousers, and they will need waterproofs if it is wet. We do have waterproofs in school, but again, at this current time, we're not allowed to offer those out. So it would be worth perhaps over the summer investing in a pair of waterproofs. Normally the all-in-ones are very good, so that your child can access forest school weathers, because that's how they learn. They learn about the seasons, they learn about the changing weather, they learn about nature, and they learn about the animals that live out there. So it is an important and integral part of our learning and of our school. Uniform is not statutory in nursery. I know some parents prefer to send their children in a St. Leonard's uniform, so they feel part of the bigger picture. However, it's not part of the, it's not enforced that they have to wear a school uniform. What we do ask is, if they're wearing their own clothes, please make sure that they are suitable for nursery. And by this, I mean not your Sunday best or your party dresses, sensible shoes, sensible footwear, clothes that you're not going to get too upset about if they come home a bit muddy or a bit paint splashed. Because what we don't want to be doing is stopping children from exploring and enjoying the environment they're in, whether that's in the outdoor area, whether it's in the classroom, whether it's in forest school. So I normally, if I'm meeting with parents at the actual meeting, will say go to somewhere like Primark. Just stock up on a sort of like a selection of clothes that they can come in, and if they do get muddy or paint on them, then they're easy to wash, but also they're not costing you a fortune. They will need names, so especially things like coats, which they're going to take off, shoes, which we'll take off when we get changed from forest school and PE. It's really important that the names are in it, because these things are easily lost. If it's a school uniform, that's quite easy to name. If it's our own clothes, you might be more reluctant. But the difficulty is going to be that if they take and discard parts of their clothing throughout their session at nursery, that we can't always guarantee they will recognise it at the end of that session. So where possible, I would ask that you spend some time over the summer thinking, what clothes are they going to be wearing to nursery, and could you possibly just label those or put their initials in. Forest school, there will be a kit list for forest school. They will need wellies, like I said previously. They will need sensible outdoor shoes. And even in the hottest of days, we do still ask for long, lightweight trousers and a long, lightweight top, because there will be brambles out there. And we do encourage children to take risks and manage their own risks. So we do sort of try and avoid t-shirts and shorts so the legs and arms don't get scratched. Hot weather, they will need a sun hat. Cold weather, they'll need hat and gloves. And who knows what the weather will be like in September, so just be prepared. So let's talk toileting. I'm aware that some of our children coming in have only just turned three, and you might be busy at home working on toilet training, and you might have good days and you might have bad days, and we're well aware of this. What we ask is that we try and work together. We do have facilities where we can change children. We are again governed by the current restrictions that if children are soiling or wetting themselves regularly, then it makes it more difficult for us, because obviously we're trying to limit that direct contact with children. But this is something we will discuss with you when we know more and whether the situations change in September. However, what I would ask is that you bring in, your child brings in a spare set of clothes and some change of clothes. So if they do have an accident, we can change them, because we don't have a huge amount of spare clothes in nursery. And experience has always shown that children much prefer to have their own clothes to put on rather than those of a stranger that they don't know. Again, we are running out of time for you to be able to contact us and discuss this in more detail, but if you do feel that it's an ongoing concern about toileting, then obviously, you know, you can contact us and we can have a telephone conversation with you in September. What I would ask is that you take the next few weeks to work with your child if there are any concerns over toileting, so hopefully these can be ironed out before September. And also, just a word of caution, sometimes once children start nursery, because they're so much more engaged during the day and there's lots of new things for them to take in, lots of new challenges, lots of new friendships, they can be really tired when they come home, and sometimes they sleep so deeply that they forget to wake up if they need the toilet. And I've had parents sort of talk to me and say, well, they've wet the bed, and are they worried about anything, are they regressing? And normally we find within those first few weeks it is just because they're tired. If they have accidents in nursery and they've not had accidents for months, it can be because they're so busy, engaged and playing. So there's nothing massive for any of us to worry about. However, if that continues, then obviously we will work with you and explore it further. So how can you help? I mean, obviously the big thing for us in nursery is the parent partnership. That's been really tested and challenged at the moment due to COVID and due to the fact that we can't sort of actually talk face to face or invite you into nursery. But it's what you do to support your child at home. We are hoping in September to send home a sharing book, and the sharing book will be for you to use at home as a scrapbook with your child to put in photos of people who are important to them, things that you do, places that you go, and that acts as a talking point when they bring it back into school to share with us, to talk about people they are familiar with. If they're feeling unsettled, we can have a look at it and share it together. So we will send that home once we know that we're allowed to, with a covering note to sort of explain what that is for and how it works. When you're at home, it's all those things that you're doing already, sharing lots of books, sharing rich language, talking to each other when you're out and about, counting, looking for signs in the environment. And the big one really is just having that language and conversation with your child that is meaningful. Okay, so this just leaves for me to say goodbye. I will be putting this presentation and the PowerPoint along onto the website. So hopefully if you need to go through it, sort of there are notes there to sort of support the pictures and the things that I've said today. Like I said, we are closing on Thursday, so obviously there is limited time to sort of contact us before the summer holidays. However, we are back in school on the Monday and the children aren't back in nursery till Thursday. So if you have got anything that you need us to contact you with, then send an email to the office and we will phone you as soon as possible. I'd like to wish you all a lovely summer. Take care and look forward to meeting you all and welcoming your children into school in September. Thank you.
Tell everybody. skies ahead, yes, I'm on my way.